Hi, this is Justice. I'm going to do a quick overview on Rebelle 8. I have some new bristle brushes that I'm sharing for free in the Discord community. We have a Discord for Rebelle. It's a fan-hosted Discord group, and there's a lot of wonderful artists in there that would love to meet you and would love to do art as a community with you. So if you're interested in getting these free bristle brushes, then head over there. I'll have those posted in the brushes category. And all you have to do is drop the zip folder onto the canvas inside of Rebelle to get those to install. All right, let's take a look at these brushes. As always, I like to give them overly theatric names. I just like it. So let's look here. This first one is called AI Web. It does these really cool little intricate twists and turns with angles. This looks robotic as well as spidery. All right, and Ancient Lumber. This one, and the purpose of these brushes is to give you a starting point for where you start working on your brushes. In this video, I will talk a little bit about the brush creator for bristles to give you an idea. This one has, inside of the brush creator, it has the color noise per bristle as well as the default color set. So these are designed, again, to give you something where you're like, okay, well, this one has a defined color and it has color noise, so let me look at that, and I'm going to learn from this brush. You can, of course, choose a different color. And we can mix these, and the mixing is beautiful and lovely. One thing I would recommend, the bristle brushes tend to mix at a lower pressure level. So on your computer, you may want to set your pressure level lower. Inside of Rebelle, you can go to Preferences, and then down inside of Tablet, Pressure Sensitivity near the bottom, changing this to Firm will give you a better response. If you can do that system-wide, that might work even better, but play around with it and comment. Let others know what worked best for you. All right, here's the next one. This one is called Angel Hair. Was likely hungry at the time of writing the names. This one's delicate and smooth. If you make it large, it's still so quick. And I'm using a Surface Pro 11. This is the base model that uses ARM. And I'm running OBS, recording audio and video and the screen. And it still does a wonderful job of moving quickly through there. The next one, this one is called Apocalypse Agony, of course. And this one is the small version of the Apocalypse Agon. So for me, this reminds me of kind of deconstructed buildings and kind of a sense of decay, ruins, this type of thing, as if an apocalypse has already happened. This does a lot of great polygon shapes of varying opacity. The way this one is done is in shape and bristles. Down here, we're using just thick. Note the dot next to the word thick. I have width turned really high with jitter turned halfway and quality. This one is going to make it basically repeat faster or slower, less or more. So here, this will be basically more opaque. This one will be less opaque, but it's not just the opacity that changes. You notice that it doesn't fill in quite as much detail. So you can play with that. Well, the width here, this is what's making it larger versus smaller. I've noticed sometimes that the screen kind of stops accepting stylus input. And if you're using the beta or early access, what you might need to do is press Control D to deselect. Somehow a selection was made on the screen, and I'm sure they'll figure that part out. All right, this next one is called Battleground. Notice again, we can't do anything at the moment, so we're going to do deselect. This one just has this expressiveness to it that seems jagged and war-torn. It's just a little bit grungy, but at the same time has kind of a knife's edge to it. By the way, if you guys have not tried yet color sliders, the option here for sliders gradient, I'm a big fan of this. It makes a lot of things a lot easier, at least for the style that I like. All right, the next one, this is Bristle's ribbon. This one actually is one of theirs. So I will pull this one from there because you already have it. Broken bristles. It's just wavy and jittery and interesting. What makes this one do all the extra jitters and wiggles is shape and bristle rotation follow trajectory. This is on. If I turn this to none, note how smooth this brush works. Follow trajectory. Now, I don't know if some of these things are happening because of design. Not design, however, we will use it to create interesting things. This one is called Fine Liner. Now I have Nanopixel version 2 turned on, which is just called Nanopixel. Right here in Visual Settings, keyboard shortcut F12, and you can see Nanopixel is on. Now the line itself actually is not jittery. Notice here that there's these little ridges inside of the line. It's not perfectly clear or clean, not vector-like. If you don't like that, if it drives you a little crazy, you can click on Canvas Size, Image Size, make sure that it's turned on, DPI 200. Bring that higher up to 400, 500, or 600. It will lag your machine out. If you using a lower powered machine like I am, however, it will make that nice and smooth and clean and crisp. This next one is called Finer Liner. And this one is, as the name implies, it's just more delicate. It's a little bit more fine, a little smaller than the Finer Liner. Than the fine liner. Yes, designed to be confusing. Designed to be interesting to say. This one is called Lion's Mane. It has this lovely swirly aspect that reminds me of, unsurprisingly, the mane of a lion. Paint tube, this one I like a lot. Let's make this metallic. You can see how fat chunky this is. Next one Putty knife. I am not a traditional artist, and so this may be the wrong name, but here what this does is this allows you to move around the paint and shape it. So this one, like this, it is not perfect yet and it needs to be refined. I have not had time to do that at the moment, but if you figure out how to make it smoother and better, please let me know. I don't actually like the rakiness to it. I would rather that it was a little bit more flat. So if someone can figure that out, that would be a great help to the community. And again, post how to do that, preferably in the Discord channel. This is being done here. What I have is I have thin, thick, and edges all on. And I'm also set in blend mode 4. But notice here in thin and thick, we don't have much impasto adding. And remove impasto is set low. Again, here in thick, which is the primary one we're using, add impasto is set at 0. And in edges also set low. So that would be where I would play around with those inside of the bristle brush creator. Texture strength, texture contrast, these may affect that. And the last one is called the wave. Let's pick something wavy colored. Well, turquoise, which I love having these names on. It really makes me feel better as an artist. Here you have color set, show color names. As a digital artist, being able to look at a color and go, oh, that's cobalt turquoise, because normally it's like that's blue with a little green in it. Knowing the names for me is very rewarding. So this is my ocean wave brush. Nice with metallics though on that one. All right, you guys, these are the free brushes. I will have brushes for sale at some point in the Discord channel. So go check that out. And I'll put the link to the Discord in the comment section as well as in the description of this video. And also, if you guys are wondering, on the left side, I have the Artist Pad from Tablet Pro. This is a tool that we have developed to work perfectly with painting software. So if you guys are using a tablet, I use these all the time to make my device very Wacom Express Key like, except for these are more customizable and more powerful. And then there's the radial menu. It allows you to do all sorts of things one-handed, as well as switching back and forth between painting, blending, erasing, with a single click of the stylus, and it's very easy and quick to set up. You would just open the radio menu with the side button, you would hold on a button, then you'd assign it, and that allows you to quickly toggle back and forth between these actions. Okay. All right, you guys have a wonderful day. Until next time, stay creative and have a even more than wonderful day. Hate repeating the same word over and over. All right, take care.